Tom asks, is there a best way for an adult to learn the keyboard? You want to make sure that you are dedicated to what you're doing. Learning the piano is not something that's easy. You're not going to learn the piano overnight, and you're not going to, you're going to go through a long amount of time where you are not playing at the level that you know you want to be at. I would definitely recommend sticking with it, knowing that like the first 6 months even, you might not be playing the kind of stuff you want to play, right? Even the first year, you might not be where you want to be. This is a thing that you have to devote yourself to. That being said, it comes down to your goals. If you're looking to kind of gain some practical piano skills so you can play some songs and maybe sing along with what you're playing, there's actually some online methods that are really good, and I'll link to a couple of them in the comments, or in the description, sorry. If you have the financial resources, get a teacher. Like, definitely find a piano teacher. Find one who will work with you at your level. If you're looking for more of a traditional skill set, like being able to read music, being able to play pieces of music that you read, I'd say just start with an adult piano method book. I usually recommend the Alfred series just because it's comprehensive and really broken down into steps that is broken down really well. So this question came from somebody after a show one time. We were talking about music after a show, and they asked me, what is the lowest note? Which is an interesting question, and the answer is kind of boring. Human hearing bottoms out around 20 hertz, depending on a lot of different factors. So the lowest note of the piano, an American piano, is an A. This A, and it is at around 27.5 hertz. So 27.5 hertz is the lowest note. Now, if this was a real piano, you'd be hearing the overtones in that string pretty much as you were hearing the fundamental frequency itself. This is a keyboard, and so we're hearing a sample of a real piano. So we can hear stuff, but it kind of sounds like a mush, and a lot of that is because we're not really hearing a fundamental frequency very strongly. There are pianos that are made in Europe. Bösendorfer makes pianos that go down to the C below this, which I think is 16.5 hertz. So that's actually below even like good human hearing. Russ has a question about hemiolas. So the hemiola usually refers to three beats occupying the space of two beats, or two beats occupying the space of three beats. So one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. If you want to practice counting the hemiola, the easiest way to do it is by doing something like this. So with your one hand, go like this. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. And then with your other hand, you're going to go bop, 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 bop. Take your one hand and go like this. Bop, 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 bop. One, two, three, one, two. One, two. With the other hand, you go ba 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 da ba da 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 da. One, two, three. One, two, three. And you can do that forever. It's just a simple polyrhythmic figure, probably like the most simple one, right? 2/3 or 3/2. Thanks a lot for watching. And if you have any questions, just put them in the comments below. And be sure to let me know if you don't want me to use your name or your photo.